eto na, guys. Guys, naalala ba to? Counter natin sa Katipunan. Now functions as a divider, a cabinet for the staff. And then, guys, this is our old table in Katipunan. Bagong finish lang siya. Our neon light.
From Katipunan, is up.
Hi, guys!
Ito na naman tayo!
Sa isa na naman pong episode ng Common Room! Hi, guys! I'm Roma.
I'm Maan.
Of Common Room!
Hello. Sabi sa script, joke mag-update daw kami ng studio.
How has it changed?
Eh, well, fully operational na siya. All the web orders, dino na talaga siya fino-fulfill. Maayos na rin yung stockroom.
Ayos na yung sections ng studio. Dito na rin nag-work yung Pop Junk Love team. So, yes. Yung pangarap namin na we have a separate office space, meron na talaga. And then, for the first time, Pop Junk Love, parang meron na kaming isang wall of samples ng lahat ng dolls na ginawa namin.
Hindi na kami sinisiksik sa mga kung ano-anong kanto sa bahay.
Yes! We have lights, finally. Common living space. Our co-making, co-working space is already finished. We already have a space dedicated for our web team, for the products. It's already functional in a way, so we're really happy with the progress. Tried to repurpose everything that we had in Katipunan. Our old counter in Katipunan is now actually a shelf, cabinet, divider for our web team. Then our big table in Katipunan is now our co-working space for the content team. Our goal is to really limit our expenses. So most of the things that you will see in...
Wala rin kasi tayong pang wala rin pambili
eh. Pandemic.
Kaya gusto natin bumili, hindi natin afford it.
Yung mga upuan namin sa lanay ng Katipunan, we reused it, we repainted it. Of course, we made a lot of new shelves for the stocks kasi we have a bigger space here compared to Katipunan. So, mostly dun lang napunta yung construction. Other than that, everything is repurposed na. To maximize the space. Yeah. Because this isn't just for web space. In the future, we're thinking of holding also field trips here and
workshops. So, medyo pang long term yung the way we wanted to design it. While very limited yung pwede namin gawin as of the moment, marami kaming pwedeng gawin sa space in the future. So we were taking those into consideration na para at least, yun nga, hindi madoble yung trabaho, hindi rin madoble yung kailangan namin gawin or bilhin for it. So,
common room ang concern, guys. Maximizing the space pa rin talaga. Kasi pag small business ka talaga, every investment, every money that you put into anything should be something that you can really maximize. So, yun talaga ang consideration of all the design decisions that we made in the space. So, wala kaming budget! Bawal kaming gastos. Definitely, may gastos. Pero hindi siya sobrang laki. I don't think umabot na kami ng 50. Kasi nga, we repurpose most of the things here.
Siguro yung pinaka-gastos would be like the logistical stuff. Yung rent, yung advance,
yung pag-move-in. Yes, yung mga overhead lang of the studio, yung trucking.
Yung trucking and all.
Definitely, hindi pa siya aabot ng 50.
Siguro
guys.
Monetary-wise, yung budget nga, sabi nate 50. But I guess ang pinaka-puhunan talaga here would be the time and effort of like really transporting all the inventory from Katipunan here.
And also guys, kasi since it's the pandemic, diba, and you have a community of staff and workers with you, maipapaisip ka kung gagastos ka, parang will it be worth it instead of just devoting or using those resources for your staff? Medyo actually mas madali in a way kasi we don't have to submit our designs. Kumbaga,
wala mag-a-approve. Engineer, ganyan. Oo,
kasi sobrang hirap kasi sa mall talaga everything should be given a go signal. Like for example, the lighting, the color, the everything should be should be approved. Dito, hindi talaga. So, parang... And then when you go to a mall, kasi the space you'll get is bare. So you'll really start from scratch. Hindi mo siya madaling madi-DIY. Unlike this studio space, it's in a residential area. The house, while it's bare, it's already functional. It has rooms, it has a bathroom, it has a kitchen, it has a garage. Kumbaga, andito na yung structure, unlike sa mall talaga that you'll really start from scratch. Mm-hmm. Definitely yung gastos pwede mong bawasan.
Tsaka I guess when we were designing it talaga, functional siya for us. For hindi siya for the shoppers. Yeah. Hindi yung parang, ah, maganda siya, aesthetic siya. Well, of course, knowing us, gusto namin visually nice pa rin siya kasi ganun kami mag-operate, di ba? Pero how will this work for us, for our staff? As in, yun talaga yung major consideration na hindi yung parang, ah, dito yung neon light kasi makakita ng mga tao, mapapadaan sa light.
I guess yung pinaka-mistake namin here would be, we could have maybe negotiated more on the things that the owner can do before we moved in. Kasi livable naman talaga siya. But for example, siguro yung gate na papinturahan namin ng white, yung mga ganun, yung dapat sila na yung gagawa, hindi namin naisip agad. So napinturahan na nila. So nakakahiya na magsabi na,
pahabol. Pahabol request. Ang dami namin yun nga, mga na-overlook na pwede naman namin i-request dun sa own. Pag-paint, tabas, mga damo-damo.
Sobrang excited namin mag-move in na nung pina-ocular to see if may ipapagawa pa, hindi man lang namin binuksan yung screen door kung gumagana. Kasi yung screen door, hindi pala nabubuksan. Kumbaga, kunwari, may uwang lang siya pero wala siyang hinge.
Oh, yeah.
So, parang, bakit hindi functional yung screen? Yeah.
Siguro ano, parang ang mistake masyado tayong na-excite, nadaan kami sa emotion.
Diba?
Yeah, siguro kung mag-ocular kayo, parang yung unang ocular nyo, doon kayo may excite. So ilabas nyo na lahat ng mga kilig-kilig nyo. Tapos gawa ulit kayo ng second, third ocular na medyo ano na kayo, level-headed. Yeah. Medyo mas logical na kayo mag-isip. So mas makikita nyo na yung mga kailangan yung gawin. Hindi yung nadaan lang kasi sa excitement. Ooh! Garden! Pwede na magka-garden dito.
Ah! Alam nyo guys, sa totoo lang, mahal mag-DIY ah.
Yes.
Sobrang mahal.
Sobrang misnomer yan na makakatipid ka pag mag-DIY ka.
Okay, so ika-clarify natin yan. Yeah. When you're DIYing and you're starting out as a DIYer, expect that it will really be more expensive because you don't have everything. Eh. Yes. You don't have the tools, you don't have the materials. So those are the things that you need to buy in the beginning. Mm-hmm. So that you can DIY whatever. But if you've been doing it for a very long time, then it becomes cheaper and cheaper.
Meron ka nang, nag-invest ka na initially. When you're starting out as a DIYer, expect din kasi na magkakamali ka.
Yes.
So meron kang mga materials na, shock, sayang, mali yung pagka-paint ko sa kanya or mali yung pagka-lagari mo sa kanya. So,
you have to think of a longer use for the materials. If you think you're going to DIY for a very long time, then I guess it's going to be a safe investment. For us, it's really easier to DIY now because we have all the materials. Everything that you see here are all from our old stuff. We didn't have to buy anything anymore from our old construction, etc. May sobra pa kaming cemento, may sobra pa kaming wood, we have sobra pa kaming sanding sealer. Those are the things that we already have because we've been DIYing for a long time. But if you're just going to do it for a one-time project, definitely mas mahal, guys, because you can definitely find furniture and fixture na sobrang mura and very well made for a fraction of the price that you need to buy.
Parang hindi pa maubos yung oras mo sa actually paggawa noon. Kasi ready na siya eh. Kakain din kasi ng oras yung mag-experiment ka and all. Ilang araw din yun kung gagawa ka ng DIY puan or what, diba? Hindi lang siya monetary cost, but also your time and effort would play in the picture of how much DIY would really cost you in total.
When you're buying materials, hindi ka makakabili ng tingi. Or like, can I just buy 6x6 wood? Wala ganun. Ang mabibili mo 4x8 agad. Yeah, ganyan. Yeah. So, yun yung mga consideration mo. So, if you're going to do it for a long time, yes, definitely DIY. But if you're just using it for one time kasi gusto mong makatipid, baka hindi ka makakatipid. There are a lot of things you can still expect. We haven't tackled the big garden yet. Yes, the big talahib. And this whole area will be our photo area, video area. So, you'll see a lot of updates here. We're so excited to show you. Makikita yung mga may pa-background na kami ng konti, di ba? Sa mga videos. Konti-konti na. Yun, i-DIY natin ang props. Plant updates. Definitely, we'll fill the space with plants.
May mga pa-konti-konti na kaming halamang, ano, minu-move in. So, eventually, magiging gubat na rin siya.
Namin, medyo extra nahirapan kami because it's our first time to actually light a space for a co-working area. Kasi since it's a studio, right, it's not a shop. It can't be totally moody. If you go to our shop in different malls, you'll see that we have a certain vibe, warm light. Kasi we're creating a mood eh. That's our branding, that's our look, that's our feel.
Tsaka syempre yung ganung light mag-work best talaga siya for the products.
Yes, but since it's an office, it cannot be
mood lighting lang. Kasi syempre, yung mga ate namin magta-type.
Kailangan makita
nila. Kailangan mabasa nila yung mga inventory.
Makita nila yung mga kinakat nilang patterns. So, for the lights, you need to know also the function of the lights. Will it be for mood or will it be functional? Yeah. So for us, the reason why we use cool white is a mix of warm and daylight because we want to still have that somehow the mood, hindi siya masyadong puti. Hindi naman siya mukhang bahay. But it's still functional for a co-working space and a studio space. And another consideration na grabe talaga sa lighting dito sa studio namin is we really have high ceiling to be able to change the lights in the event na
mapundi
siya. Kailangan namin na scaffolding. So, we really had to drop most of the lights.
Mababa. Para maabot.
Yes. We don't have natural light.
Yeah.
That's why.
Big consideration is malaki siyang space pero yung windows.
Small.
Small. Tapos kahit may windows, hindi siya directly pinapasok ng araw.
Because we have lots of trees, which is good. Yeah. But wala kaming natural light. And
it's not streaming inside the space talaga.
But syempre for plantitas like us, na ang dream talaga ay hindi gumawa ng studio, guys. Gumawa ng garden sa loob ng studio. Kailangan namin ng natural light. That's why you're going to see that most of our windows have a line of lights so that in the event na maglalagay kami ng plant doon, somehow, meron silang light. Yeah. When we go to our bodega, hindi din siya super yellow because again, it's not a store. So again, we opted for cool white because it's more of a stockroom. So kailangan makita nila ate yung anik-anik na pinagtatago nila dyan na mga stock. Guys, maraming nag-a-ask sa amin about bunting lights kasi di ba kilala kami sa parang a string of a lot of bulbs. You really need to be careful lang talaga while meron kayong ma-hire na electrician to make your own bunting lights. Ang pinaka-importante doon is that you have the correct size of wire because may total watts yung bawat bulb na gagamitin nyo. The main wire that will connect all of them should be able to carry the load of all those lights. Okay. We have different sizes naman of wire. So, hindi naman problema yon. If you can opt for LED, mas mahal talaga siya. But in the long run, mas efficient siya kasi hindi mahal sa kuryente. So most of the common room stores, we had help from our go-to interior designer friend, Anais Silvestre.
Yes, fellow plant mom, fellow BTS fan.
Fellow crafter and maker, potter, ganyan. So talagang nagkakasundo talaga kami, jive na jive kami. So we'll go around the space and also ask for tips kasi since DIYers kami, we probably did something wrong somewhere. So talagang may mga makukuha tayong tips on lighting kasi again, it's not our specialty. So let's see if tama yung mga ginawa natin and hopefully may matutunan kayong tips na rin
from when we go around.
From a professional. Yes. Correct.
Okay.
I was surprised na konti lang yung natural lighting nyo from your windows.
Yeah.
Kasi the video looks very bright.
Mm-hmm.
That's a good sign already na if you don't need to add lighting to your phone or to your video, then obviously your lighting's pretty okay. Very good attempt at DIYing your own lights. Now to further improve if you want, when you're designing lights, important to consider three things. The layering of your lights, the general lighting or the ambient lighting, which is what people usually describe as natural lighting, yung mukhang maaliwalas. Now the second type of lighting is your task lighting. That's important when you define the function of your spaces. Like, for example, what I'm looking at now, that's your work area, di ba? So, what tasks do you usually do in that in your work area? And that determines what kind of task lighting you need. And then the third lighting, which is probably the least of your priorities right now, is the mood lighting. So, if you want to add a bit more drama and turn off everything else,
yes,
that's mood lighting.
Oh my gosh.
Crash course on lighting. Layering.
Sobrang layering. Ganda nung sinabi mo dahil I know now the problem of our studio. We don't have ambient.
Yes.
You know why, Anna? Look at the ceiling. It's so high. We need to drop everything. So most of them are task lighting because if we put ambient here, we won't be able to change it. We need scaffolding to change it in the future.
Actually, I'm impressed nga by the length of the wires.
So, Anna, kung lalagyan ko to ng ambient, paano ko to lalagyan ng ambient? Na hindi na kami magsa-scaffolding sa future.
But you can also locate, usually sa mga discrete corners, like yung baba ng railings na yan, pwede ka mag-add ng diffused na floodlight. Now, if you want to add light for an artwork in that wall, then you add a spotlight also somewhere, maybe somewhere beside the floodlight, beside or above the floodlight.
So, yeah, Anna, so when we say ambient, this is daylight?
Surprisingly, ang ambient lighting, for me, the best is cool white.
Cool white pa rin. Yay! Dami ng changes! Medyo hindi na kami nahihiyang picturean siya kasi medyo kumukyut na siya. And sobrang daming flowers kasi pa-Valentine's na, guys.
Yes, so may mga konting halaman na rin, mga plant babies here and there. So,
yeah, dami ng progress but marami pa rin kaming gagawin. Hopefully, ma-invite na namin kayo soon and maging ready na siya and sana safe na maka-visit. So, yun, we're so excited. We're preparing this space so it can be ready when it's already time and safe to visit here at the studio.
Yes.
So there, hope you enjoyed the episode. Hopefully you'll get to see more episodes about our progress here at the studio. So yun, bago pa maging novela ulit ang aming episode. Bye!